Thank you so much for this beautiful lecture. And we have time for questions and answers. And I'm pretty sure today we learn a lot, right? So from a tradition that many or some of you didn't know before. I can open up the question answer from the floor. And you can simply, well, raise your hand, otherwise would be a bit of chaos here. But and then Kenzo will answer, right?
My name is Aline. Today I am the professor of student. I, of course, call it a privilege to listen to you. Thank you very much, because indeed, it appears to me that Tibetan Buddhism sort of privileges the boy child more than the girl child. It looks like it appears to me as if Tibetan Buddhism privileges men more than women. Is it a fair criticism to say that Tibetan Buddhism practice gender discrimination? The second thing I wanted just to find out is the position of Tibetan Buddhism as far as same-sex relationships are concerned. Thank you very much.
这样的，藏传佛教其实对 男性和女性呢应该是同等看待的，因为藏传佛教的仙宗当中的话呢，实际上是 男性的这种戒律啊，女性的戒律啊都可以受持的。然后到了那个密宗的时候呢，密宗里面有一个戒律，就是说对这个女性的话呢，就是不能诽谤，不能侮辱，就是这是一个特殊的这个戒律。但除此之外呢，我好像没有看到过这个藏传佛教当中，就是男性比女性就是高的，就重男轻女的这样的这种现象，在佛教当中呢是没有的。但是在历史上呢有没有呢？就是可能在民间呢，也许可能是有的，因为我们整个东西方也好，非洲也好，很多地方呢，人类的历史是。在我们这个20世纪之前的话，基本上是有很多不平等的现象，这是第一个问题。
To respond to your first question is that in terms of equality of the sexes, in fact, in exoteric Buddhism, the precepts for men and women are the women and men can take precepts. They have same rights to take precepts. And in terms of esoteric or the Tantrayana, there's a one particular precept that man has to take. That is, you cannot look down upon women and humiliate women. That's a very special precept that man has to take. So it's quite important to note that in Buddhism history, there's no such, in Buddhism, there's no such particular teachings that looks down upon women. There's, in fact, quite a lot of emphasis on the equality of both sexes. Yet, in terms of history and in terms of the local culture that Buddhism is immersed in, the culture, doesn't matter if it's from the West or the East or Africa, before 20th century, there's a general culture of inequality. But after 20th century, I think nowadays the equanimity of the both sexes are promoted. So it's really not in terms of Buddhism, there is a difference of the treatment of both sexes, yet in terms of local culture, in terms of our society statuses, there were some differences happening in the history.
第二个问题，本身那个梵语， 贪欲的话，不管是异性的贪欲也好，同性的贪欲，在仙宗的经典当中呢，就是这是就是不合理的一种烦恼，所以佛陀在佛经当中，就是包括《正法念处经》当中的话呢，都讲就是不合理的这种作意，就是对同性产生也不好，对异性产生也不好，就是有制止的。然后到了密宗的有些最高境界的时候呢，贪心就是就妙观察智，就是他的本性是智慧的，就是也有这样的。所以呢，在佛教它本身的这种这个藏传佛教当中呢，就是对同性恋并没有特别的去排斥，但是在藏地的这个传统当中呢，可能同性恋是一般都很难接受，就是因为在历史也好，它的整个生活习惯当中的话呢，以前也是就是人们是不能接受的，包括现在的话呢，也是如果一提起了，就像现在国际上的同性恋结婚啦、同性恋合法，很多我们可能在藏地的这种传统的话，大家都觉得是非常稀有，就是一般都可能大家都就难以接受。我跟有些藏族人也说过，就是现在有些国家同性恋结婚是这个合法的，就然后他们就非常不可思议，不可能就。怎么样也是没办法的，就是所以藏地是比较封闭的一个世界，就是所以可能在民间的话呢，就是他们可能很难接受。
In terms of homosexuality, the greed we talk about in Buddhism is really the same. The kind of desire to long for companionship to either a person that is same gender or of different gender, that kind of greed, desire is the same. So in exoteric sutras and teachings, it is taught that that kind of greed should be eliminated. Therefore, it doesn't matter if it's towards a person of same gender or towards a person of a different gender, it's the greed.That it generates from your mind should be eliminated. In Tibetan Buddhism, however, in esoteric or the Tantrayana teachings, that kind of greed can be, in fact, the nature of such greed can be found as the wisdom, the wisdom that you can practice and be able to realize. So in terms of homosexuality, it's not in Buddhism, homosexuality is not in a subject of objection, but it's rather the culture in local areas, such as in Tibetan areas, that's not accepted somehow because of the history, because of the habits of Tibetans. That is not really well known to the Tibetans, as it's a rather closed area and people are not very much exposed to that. Nowadays, we do talk a lot about the marriage of same sexes and to make same-sex marriage lawful. But that's not generally accepted by the Tibetans, not because of their religion, but rather because of their habit or cultural understanding. As I spoke to some Tibetans about nowadays, internationally, there are same-sex marriages, and the Tibetans are all in awe and very much surprised that how could two people of same sexes can be married. So my point is, it's not really about the Buddhism that cannot be, that cannot accept same-sex marriage or homosexuality, but rather it's the local culture that is rather close and not be able to, not really, rather exposed to that aspect of society.